Poetry fam. Welcome back to the channel with your boy, your host, the one and only, Marcus T. This guy. And we are back with another Kitchen Conversations video. I got this back brace thing on, so I gotta make sure my back is straight. Right? It's been a roller coaster, right? Conversation for another day, right? But Kitchen Conversations video, right? What's supposed to be after that? Oh, yeah. Some of y'all might not know what these videos are about. I'll let you know. But first, you gotta do something for me. I need you guys to go ahead and like, comment, share, and subscribe to the channel. And once you've done that, be sure to turn on that notification bell so that you can be notified every time we hear a life and poetry drop a new video. And remember, guys, that I say we, because you never know what's gonna pop up and grace us with their presence here on the channel. Some faces may be old, some faces may be new. You never know. That's why you have to stay tuned and stay connected, right? So now that's out the way, guys. Kitchen Conversation videos, what is this about? The Kitchen Conversation videos are videos that we do while in the kitchen on topics that relate to my life, possibly your life, current events, whatever it may be, random conversation, raw conversation, an edited conversation, and just pure straight conversation in the kitchen, right? Now, I can be in the kitchen either cooking, cleaning, or just sitting in the floor, or standing up in the middle of the floor, right? Flat-footed, I'm still holding on to the countertop though, but just having conversations, right? But today, guys, this video is going to be comprised of me cleaning and disinfecting these countertops, washing these little dishes that I made this morning, while having a conversation with you guys. It's going to be so pure, so raw, and I'm being transparent today, guys. So stick with me as we go on this journey here, as we clean up these countertops, right? You got to have that Clorox all-purpose spray, right? You got to have that. You know, if I had this pure bleach, I would probably have made some bleach water in it like that, too, but yeah. But yeah, so while I'm spraying this stuff down here, guys, I want to give you guys just, you know, a quick synopsis of what we're going to talk about, because it's in me being transparent, I want to make sure that, you know, I don't leave nothing out, and I want to make sure that I can get through this here without, you know, getting tearful or whatever that may be, so on and so forth, right? But got my what's the thing, cut brushes. But guys, it's been some stuff that's been weighing on me lately, and I really wanted to talk about it. So I was like, what better place than to do it here with you guys at Life and Poetry, right? So now that I sprayed down, so I want to talk to you guys about something I've been dealing with for some time, which is, you guys know, you've been with me for so long. You've been rocking with me since the beginning of time. Me learning to walk again, right? I wanted to address this here, and this is a hot button topic for me. Because it has been a while. It's going on six, seven years now since this happened. And sorry about the noise. It's been about 6, 7 years since this happened. And it's still not really changing. I mean, it's changing, but at the same time, it's not as progressive as I want it to be. But that's fine. You know, that's okay, right? I still don't know. There's still no deadline or timeline on when this is going to happen, when it's going to change, so on and so forth. But I know it's going to happen, right? But most recently, I've been realizing that I've been getting kind of jealous of people that can walk, right? Now, stick with me, right? It's not like I hate them because they can walk. It's like I miss being able to do what they can do. You know, I miss being able to just go outside on my own accord and do things on my own. And just be free with it, you know. I miss being able to do that. And I know it's going to be a time where I can do it again. But as of right now, I can't, you know. And I'm looking at people around and they just living their best lives and stuff. And just having a ball with everything they're doing. And again, I'm not envious or anything of it. It's just every time I see it, it's a reminder that, okay, this is who I am now. This is where I am, and this is where I'm going to be for some time. But I guess in the same breath, what I would say is, although I may get jealous from time to time, it does nothing to me but, you know, fuel that fire in me to get back on my feet and do what I have to do. Like, making sure I'm keeping up with my PT and stuff, you know. And that, for me, goes a long way. Just being able to keep up with that PT side, you know, because PT, for me, really is what got me where I'm today. It got me back up, being able to do this here with you guys. Like, stand up here without without the worry of me falling over in the kitchen while I'm trying to wipe these countertops down. You know, but even in all that, it's still a lot, you know. And then I begin to realize that maybe some questions I need to answer for myself. Like, did I take walking for granted? Like, it was just something that, you know, it's an active thing to know how to walk. So why not cherish it while you have it? So I begin to reflect and begin to pray on it, especially these past couple of days. I've been having these dreams of me doing things while I'm walking and stuff and so on and so forth. I got forgiven for having my back turned to the countertop. Air bowls off a little bit on the side. But I've been having these dreams, these slight dreams, where I've been walking in the dreams and I've been doing, like, you know, crazy things, running, working. It's a lot of things that have been happening. And I take them as God showing me that that one day I'm gonna get back to that time, or not even that time, get back in that space of being able to do it. And I guess with that, it eases the blow just a little bit for me. I'm out of breath. Woo! I guess I might not be PTing as good as I used to be, huh? I gotta get back right. I actually just started PTing last week. This will be my second week back at doing my PT because some stuff had came about. But nonetheless, we're here, right? Nonetheless, we're here. But as time goes on, I guess it's not straining me per se to think about it. But it's like, man, like I used to can do that. Like I know I can still walk. I'm not discounting that. I'm not taking that from me. I'm not lessening my work that got me where I am today. I'm not doing that at all. I'm simply saying, for me, from my journey through this year, I go through these phases where I look at people and be like, dang, bruh, must be nice, you know, to just be able to go out and run or walk without having to hold on to something or somebody and not having the fear of falling, or even if you can fall, you get back up, or just simply stand off the couch without grabbing my walk or my cane, or go to the bathroom or hold onto a wall, you know. I don't know. It's been a journey. It's been a journey, and this isn't the first time this has happened. You know, like I said, they come in spouts. They come in spouts, and when they come, they come. When these spouts come, they come. But I'm beginning to realize that even in this time, even in this space, there's lessons to be learned, right? The lesson is, one, I'm learning more about my drive and my push, right? And when I was up and walking and being able to go out and do PT outside, my 2 mile run in the morning time, so on and so forth, I see now that the push I had then doesn't equate to the push I have now, right? Somebody said, oh, how's that? I'm gonna tell you how, right? See, now I have to push myself a little bit more to make sure that I'm actually giving my all. You know, when I was able up to do it, you know, you could just go out and say, I'm gonna do this run and half-ass it. But now I gotta actually give everything I got, you know, to just get up out the bed in the morning time to make sure my feet are planted flat as I'm trying to walk through and trying to avoid from walking on my toes that I've been doing for the past 5 years. You know, it's a course of action that needs to happen and a habit that needs to be broken. But I know that when the time comes, the strength that my body's gonna have is gonna be crazy. It's going to be crazy. And I speak it and I claim it. It's been prayed over and spoken over for so long. And it's been prophesized. And God has spoken to me amongst and he has given the insight to other people. And showing me, you know, that this is the change that's going to happen. And I receive it wholeheartedly. But it's not to say that the human flesh side of me doesn't sometimes go back and be like, damn, like, how did we get here? How did we get here? How did we get past this? How did we get to the other side of it all? Am I doing enough? Am I working hard enough? Do I have all the tools I need to get there? Am I lacking? Am I still scared? Am I this? Am I that? And in this time and space is where I'm beginning to truly reflect on those things. And not even just wonder, and I'm not even just wondering how or whatever it may be. I'm also sitting in a space where I'm not just learning about me, but I'm learning about others as well. I'm learning how some people look at you as if you are less than because you can't do what they can do. Or they'll look at you and judge you because you're young and you quote unquote shouldn't have to, you shouldn't be going through this here, right? At 29, 30 years, gotta be 30, a few months. You shouldn't be going through this here, right? You're too young to have to deal with this here. But is there an age limit on injury? Is there an age limit on pain? Is there an age limit on going through and dealing with something? No, there isn't. There isn't. And my prayer is truly that one day we as a people can come together and realize that just because I'm young or just because a person is young doesn't mean they can't go through something in life. Doesn't mean they can't deal with hardships, deal with pain and turmoil, because it happens. It happens. You could be 2 years old and it can happen to you. Right, there is no age limit. There's no restriction on it. There is no monopoly on injury or going through, you know. But that's why when people ask, people tell me those things, are you too young for this here? I just smile and say, you know what, ma'am or sir, I'm making it through. You know, I smile at them and I greet them with the utmost respect and courtesies, because that's what it's about. It's not about flaunting it, like, okay, yeah. It's not about receiving what they put on you. I'll say that. Because I refuse to receive what people put on me in every sense of the word receive. You know, sometimes we agree with everything that somebody tells you. Hell, I don't even agree with the doctor most of the time. And I'll tell the doctor, no, this isn't me. This isn't me. You know, I'm not that. I'm not that. It's just like when the enemy comes at you and says that you're this. You know, we have to get in a posture of making sure the enemy knows that we're not that. The enemy will come to you and say, you have this. No, I don't have that, right? Or you're that. No, I'm not that, right? But then you go back and tell them what you are. I am healed. I am set free. I am delivered, right? I am the son of the son. Amen. And that's a posture I had to learn to take. I learned that the hard way, believe it or not. I learned that one day sitting in a quiet place in the back of a church, back of my church, where as the word was being delivered, and I'm sitting in the back of the church because I can't walk to the seats. It's too far from the entry door to get to where the seats are. So I'm sitting in the back of the church, and I'm hearing the service happening. But I'm not a part of it. I'm kind of detached from it, right? That's how it felt in that time. But God spoke to me in that space, and I remember it was so clear. He said to me, he said, son, you are mine. You are mine. And in that, I got everything I needed in that time. And it that's, you know, sometimes, you know, God will give you what you need in that time to get to the next space. It's not to say that in that next space, like we know the trials, like we know the storm. Because it's going to be, it's there. It's there. It's there. No matter how much you want to pray it away, it's there, right? It's there. Your best bet is to get in your face and pray through it, right? But you got to get through it. It's not going to go away, right? You got to get through it. And I think as a believer in Christ, that's something that you learn the hard way, right? No matter how much we want to think that it's going to be all peaches and cream as we go through this, it's not true. It's not true. Walking through my storm through this process here from when my dad passed in 2011, to when I was diagnosed, either 2012 or 13. It's interesting that I don't even remember the time I was diagnosed, officially diagnosed, because I put it out of my mind. Because I'm not that. I don't have that, right? My spirit is healed. See, the vessel is going through the changes, but my spirit was already healed in the beginning of time when I came into this world. When God spoke me, he spoke healing over me. So how can I be walking in something if God says something different, right? The world may say one thing, but my God says something different. And that's where I'm at now. But again, it's not to say that I don't have those times where I misstep and I go back, because I do. I go back a lot and I reflect on things. Y'all see me, I can switch from the rag to the sponge, because there's sticky stuff. There's sticky things on the countertop I'm trying to get up off the thing. And it got that little scrappy pad on the back of the sponge. But so as I walk with God through these spaces here, I'm beginning to realize that it's okay to go through. I'm human. I'm a backstep. I'm human. As much as I don't want to, I'm a backstep. I'm going to backstep. And I'm going to admit what I backstep. I'm not going to say, oh, this didn't happen when it did happen. I'm gonna let God know that I fail, right? And I know he sees me, but I'm gonna make sure that he knows I fail. I'm gonna fight to get back up. But I'm gonna let the enemy know. I'm gonna let the enemy know that he's on notice, that he's now on notice to the situation, and that I may stumble again, but the next time I'm not gonna fall as hard. I'm not gonna fall as fast, right? And if it happens again, I'm gonna go back to the same process till he understands where I stand in the equation of things, right? But through this process, guys, again, it's coming up only the 6 or 7 years, 16, from 16, 17, 6 years, 6 years, 6 years in June. Actually, it was 6 years in February. 6 years in February. The anniversary of me not walking. Right, 6 years in February. I was discharged from one hospital in June, right? And spent the rest of that year in 2016 in and out of hospital, two hospitals, two rehabilitation facilities, countless physical therapy sessions, multiple physical therapists, multiple home aides trying to get me to where I am today. And I'm thankful for that. I'm thankful for the grit and the drive that God has given me to do this here. I'm thankful that God saw something in me to keep me. He kept me, right? I think the songwriter said, you thought I was worth keeping, right? So you sacrificed your life. God did that for me. God did it for you. He thought that we were worth keeping, right? He thought that we were worth keeping, so he sacrificed. Jesus sacrificed himself for us because he thought that we were worth keeping. He was under instruction from the Father, right? But in unity, right? He said, they're worth more. He said, Father, your creations are worth more. So I'm going to do this for them, right? And he did just that. He sacrificed himself. And it's interesting that this is the time of Passover, right? This is the time of Passover, and we talk about sacrifice, right? We talk about how as Jesus walked through the city, they laid palm at his feet as he walked over palm, right? We talk about how Jesus walked through this town or for this festival, this party here, right? And he greeted so many people. And he touched so many people as he came through. We talk about how through this time here, Jesus was crucified, right? We talk about how he came back in 3 days. We talk about all that in this time of Passover, but we forget that the rest of the time, it still counts. It still counts. It still stands true. It doesn't just happen on Easter Sunday or during the season of Passover or so. It happens from January to December, that God saw fit to give his only son so that we could be healed, set free, and delivered, right? It's a blessing to stand before you today. It's a blessing to truly stand before you today as I record this video so that you guys can get another glimpse into me. As we release another transparent video, as we open up more, as we continue to peel back the layers with these videos, with Kitchen Conversation videos, as we did the same with the Truth Unveiled series, as we will continue to do, as we continue to do here on this channel, that's what it's about. It's about having that free space to just open up and pull back those layers and to be transparent, not only with yourself, but with somebody else that may can relate to your story, that may can get something from your story, that may can pull something from your testimony, that may can they can come here and maybe just find that sense of release and relief and what they're going through because they got a word on the specific day that they needed it as they watched any one of these videos. No matter which one it was, I pray you got something from it. I pray you got something from this one. I pray you get something from every single video, every word that I may say. Amen. I pray that God not only touches you in a space of need, but he gives you more, right? He gives you more than what you want. Amen. My prayer is always that you not only receive something from me, but is that that you continue to receive something daily as I do the same. I look at all of you who followed me, who followed me and then unfollowed me, who still watch the channel. I see it in the analytics. I see you guys come to Instagram, to the TikTok. I see it. And my prayer is that each and every one of you receives overflow in your season of not only need, but want.
I pray that you receive the overflow that you need. I pray that healing bestows your body from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. And I pray that you can stand sure-footed and flat-footed in the storm of anything that you should go through in this season. I pray that this season brings you nothing but fruitfulness. I pray that this season brings you nothing but nothing short of obedience. I pray that this season, oh my God, we're going to get off here before the video turns into something different, you guys. But trust me when I say this here. As long as you keep your eyes fixed on the Father, nothing else will hold you back. Nothing will hold you back. I may not be physically walking without the cane on my walk while holding on to my wife, but my feet are still moving forward. If I fall, I know to get back up. If I can't get back up, I know the Father will carry me until my legs regain the strength that needs to press on even more. Amen. Life for you, family. I love you guys so much. I thank you guys for rocking with me. Again, this is another Kendrick Conversations video. Raw conversation, uncut conversation. I don't know. Again, this is therapeutic for me. I pray you guys got something from it. I pray that there's nothing short of, like I said, deliverance as we stand at expectation in this season. But I love you guys. Thank you guys for rocking with me. I'll finish cleaning these countertops. It's time for another wipe down. I pray you guys receive something. I pray for you guys constantly, as I pray that you pray for your neighbor as well. Love on somebody today. Cherish the thing that you have while you have them. No matter how little they may be, no matter how common it may be to you, cherish what you have. Cherish what you have. But again, guys, I love you guys so much. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to follow me on all my social media sites. Everything you need to know about me is in the description down below. Social media sites, the book stuff, everything is down there below, guys. Check everything out. I'm dropping a video today on TikTok. I'm dropping a post today on Instagram. Check them out. I pray you guys made it to the end of this video. If not, it's fine as well. Remember, guys, thumbs up, thumbs down. All love with your boy here, Life and Poetry. But we're going to finish cleaning up this kitchen here as we get this spring cleaning done. But guys, as always, I love y'all. Thank y'all for rocking with me and let me rock with y'all. So in closing out, we keep it as we do. Remember, stay safe, be blessed. Till next time, we out. Peace.